like witches at black masses. Evil minds that plot destruction. Sorcerer of death's construction.
Hello and welcome to the season finale, episode number 45 of WITM Season 8, the final match we'll witness on WWE 2K23 before we move on to WITM Season 9 and WWE 2K24 here in a few weeks from this recording. And it is a huge one because it will be the Falconclaws, represented by the leader of the NXT Falconclaws, Cabbages, representing the NXT Falconclaws, and the Raw Falconclaws, Corey, Alec Winterborn, and E-Rock, taking on the Judgment Day, Dominic Mysterio, Damian Priest, Finn Balor, and JD McDonagh. And if the Falconclaws lose, they must leave the WWE. If they win, they will be free and clear to stay in the WWE, and Corey will be able to cash in his Money in the Bank when he wishes within the year that is remaining without any interference. It is a huge match to end off WITM Season 8. Massive stakes. I cannot think of a much better way to end our time with WWE 2K23. With that said, we've had a lot of build-up and everything. Do have just a little bit more build up. We are going to head to the ring where Corey is going to address the Falconclaws prior to this huge match with massive stakes for the Falconclaws. Okay, prior to Survivor Series War Games officially beginning, Corey stands in the ring with the rest of the Falconclaws on the outside and addresses them prior to tonight's huge matchup. What does he have to say? In just a few hours from now, we will be in the war game structure together, putting everything on the line. And now, I know a lot has been said about what is at stake for me personally here tonight. But the fact is that if tonight is my last night in the WWE, while not everything has gone the way that I've wanted, I can at least say that I've been world champion 4 times, that I've main evented WrestleManias, and had other high-profile matches, and that I've led revolutions. Successful stables, and of course, WITM. But what would be even worse than that is if the rest of you did not get the opportunity to reach the massive potential that you all possess, having barely scratched the surface of what you all can accomplish this far. Now, while I know a lot about hardcore wrestling, being a former ECW wrestler, I've never competed in a War Games match before. Thankfully, Cabbages has, and was able to give me some pointers to share with the rest of you. During War Games, to be frank, you will go through hell, both physically and mentally. And during that time, every part of your body and of your mind are going to be screaming at you to stop and to give up. But you cannot give in to it, because just a moment of weakness will cost us everything that we've all built together as WITM members and as Falconclaws. So tonight, stay strong, fight as one, and let's secure our futures together, so that next time we step in a ring together, we can stand together loudly and proudly and say to everybody who has tried to hold us back, Kakam, AMFers. Okay, and with those final words said, it is time. The careers of the entirety of the Falconclaws, both from Raw and NXT, including the leader of the Raw Falconclaws, Corey, Alec Winterborn in Y-Rock, Queen Alpaca from the Raw Falconclaws, and from the NXT Falconclaws, the leader, Cabbages, the tag team of Darth and Sword, and the current NXT champion, Tiger Brown. All of them will have their careers on the line in just a few moments. If the Falconclaws win, they secure their future. They get to remain in WWE without anybody trying to stop them, any outside interference. Corey remains Mr. Money in the Bank and is free to cash in within any of the remaining years since he won the briefcase. If the Judgment Day wins, they all go away and the future of the Falconclaws will be in doubt. How we will be able to start Season 9 will be in doubt. Will we have to start Season 9 with a whole new cast of characters? We'd have to wait and see. But hopefully for the Falconclaws, that will not be the case, and they will be victorious here tonight. And now it is finally time to find out. It is time to see our final match that will take place on WWE 2K23. It is time for War Games. Cabbages, the leader of the NXT Falconclaws, teams with Corey, the leader of the Raw Falconclaws, and Raw Falconclaws Alec Winterbourne and Y-Rock to represent the Falconclaws and try to secure their futures against their longtime rivals, the Judgment Day, Dominic Mysterio, Damian Priest, Finn Balor, and JD McDonagh. Let's get War Games underway.
The following is a men's War Games match. The rules of the match are as follows. Two teams will be contained in separate cages, with one member of each team starting the match. At regular intervals, alternating members from each team will be released to enter the match. The team with the advantage will be the first to have a member released into the match. Once all competitors have entered, War Games officially begins. The match can be won by pinfall or submission. Now, let the War Games begin!
My cabbages! What kind of flum?
Introducing
you think
first,
this is?
From Asgard, weighing in at 215 pounds, KBGS.
And there's the bell. This match is underway, though not completely officially. War Games does not officially begin until each side has all four of their members in the structure. Then War Games officially begins, and the first pin or submission wins the match for your team. Starting up this match is Cabbages for the Falconclaws and Dominic Mysterio for the Judgment Day. Extremely fitting because Cabbages said he has been ashamed of Dominic Mysterio and wanted to get his hands on him ever since he disrespected his father, the legendary Rey Mysterio. Wanting to knock some respect into Dominic Mysterio, he gets an opportunity here tonight to kick off this matchup. The Falconclaws have the advantage in this matchup, so they will get a 2-on-1, 3-on-2, and 4-on-3 advantage to try to inflict as much damage as possible on Judgment Day members prior to War Games officially beginning. There's Cabbages with a backbreaker on Dominic Mysterio, still carrying an injury designation into this matchup, a minor body injury, but there is Mysterio with a reversal. The Falconclaws are about to get another member in this matchup here soon. And just 10 seconds. Okay, well, the Falconclaws wasting no time sending out their best. Both Falconclaw leaders are already in the ring for the Falconclaws. Corey, of the leader of the Raw Falconclaws. Cabbages, the leader of the NXT Falconclaws. They have a 2-on-1 advantage to try to do as much damage to Dominic Mysterio as possible. As Corey introduces three weapons into the fray. A stop sign, a table, and a sledgehammer. But now the Judgment Day are about to get an equalizer and get their second member into this matchup. Alright, Damian Priest, wasting no time introducing new weapons, he's going to use the ones that are already in play to try to assist Dominic Mysterio, who has already suffered major damage, that already injured chest in the red zone, head in the orange zone, but there's Damian Priest with a sledgehammer to the back of Cabbages. Meanwhile, Corey with the snake eyes to Dominic Mysterio. Damian Priest, a big man, but showing some of that same agility that Cabbages has with the springboard maneuver. Corey takes Priest into the left ring. Cabbages with a sledgehammer on Dominic Mysterio in the right ring. Corey puts Damian Priest through a table with a variation of the famous move 3D invented by the Dudley Boys. Right now, it is all Falconclaws, and the WWE Universe is loving every second of it, chanting, "This is awesome." Falconclaws is absolutely laying waste to Judgment Day, but there's Dominic Mysterio trying to fight back, and the Falconclaws are going to get even more help here in a matter of seconds. And Alec Winterbourne makes his way in for the Falconclaws. They have a 3-on-2 advantage. Cabbages attempts to hit the green mist, but reversed by Dominic Mysterio. Alec Winterbourne introduces some new weapons into play. A chair, a kendo stick, and another table. Corey going to work on Priest in the left ring. Cabbages and Alec Winterbourne teaming up on Dominic Mysterio in the right ring, though Cabbages coming over to help out Corey with Damian Priest. And Alec Winterbourne punishes Dominic Mysterio with a sledgehammer in the right ring. Cabbages with a chair over the head of Damian Priest. The Judgment Day is about to get some much needed help here in a few seconds. Alright, Finn Balor wasting no time, coming to the aid of his fellow Judgment Day members. There's an STO to Corey. Somebody's busted open. I believe that is Dominic Mysterio. Corey with a crossbody to Finn Balor. Cabbages shoved in that steel area in the middle of the ring. Damian Priest going springboard, nearly taking out his own fellow Judgment Day member in Finn Balor. Corey forced him to the right ring. Cabbages plants Damian Priest onto the chair as Finn Balor taunts as his partner is getting punished. Finn Balor goes springboard though and takes out Corey and nearly takes out Alec Winterbourne. Right. Corey grabs a sledgehammer and attempts to take out Dominic Mysterio but misses. Meanwhile, Cabbage is laid on top of the stop sign. Corey and Alec Winterbourne punishing Dominic Mysterio, but Mysterio able to fight back well. And the Judgment Day are about to get their final, the Falconclaws are about to get their final member in this matchup. And Ye Rock is going to waste no time as Damian Priest hits the South of Heaven, putting Cabbages through a table. But Cabbages gets right back up, only to eat a choke slam. Look at all that debris from broken tables in that left ring. It is utter chaos, and as Corey put it, press match hell. Cabbages being put through absolute hell right now. He just suffered 3 finisher signature maneuvers in a row, courtesy of Damian Priest, and yet he is trying his best to fight on. Cabbages plunging the head of Dominic Mysterio straight into the canvas. Corey has wielding a sledgehammer. Alec Winterbourne planting Finn Balor into the corner there. Cabbages wielding a steel chair, fighting Damian Priest and Dominic Mysterio, the former tag team champions, on his own and doing a good job. But now the numbers game starting to weigh on him. I believe he's been busted open. And War Games is about to officially begin as the Judgment Day are about to get their final member in this matchup. And someone else has been busted open. And as you just heard the announcement by the ring announcer, War Games has officially begun. The next pin or submission will win this matchup. If it is a member of the Falconclaws that is pinned or submitted, they must leave the WWE. And Corey, of course, will be stripped of the Money in the Bank. As you can see on the HUD, Falconclaws may have inflicted a lot of damage. However, Cabbage is very much damaged just for the Falconclaws, so while the Falconclaws basically have their pick of members that they could potentially pin or submit right now, Cabbages could be easily pin or submitted, and the Judgment Day have him completely isolated in the left ring. 3 Judgment Day members all focusing on Cabbages. A very dangerous situation for the Falconclaws. Cabbages cracked over the head with a stop sign. E-Rock coming to the aid of Cabbages. Priest trying to hit another massive maneuver on Cabbages, but he's able to fight it off. It is 3-on-2 for the Judgment Day in the left ring, 2-on-1 for the Falconclaws in the right ring, with Alec and Corey focusing on Finn Balor, who is busted open. E-Rock with a massive cutter to Dominic Mysterio. E-Rock, submission locked in on McDonough. He taps. The Falconclaws win. There's a pin attempt. I believe that was Cabbages trying to pin Dominic Mysterio, and Mysterio powered out at 2. Finn Balor is officially injured. Looks like Cabbages may be injured as well. Priest climbing the rope. He cannot escape, but he can do that. A diving elbow drop from the rope. And the Judgment Day destroying Cabbages and E-Rock right now. There's a bear hug by Priest on Cabbages. E-Rock trying to break him free. But Cabbages taps out, and the Judgment Day win. The Falconclaws must leave WWE. Okay, well, it looks like we get the bad ending to WITM Season 8 and our time on WWE 2K23. The Judgment Day, gotta give them credit. They made a wise decision to isolate Cabbages for the official War Games part of the match. The man that was the most damaged, hitting him with several finishers in a row, several weapons in a row. They were able to isolate him away in the left ring, away from the rest of the Falconclaws. E-Rock did his best to try to save him, but it was not enough. After hitting several finishers and using several weapons, Damian Priest locked in the bear hug, Cabbages tapped out, and the Judgment Day won War Games, meaning that the Falconclaws must leave WWE. And here to put the final nail in the coffin for the Falconclaws time in the WWE, Adam Pearce, the backstage executive who has been challenging Corey and the rest of the Falconclaws over the last few weeks and made the stakes for this matchup, is on his way to the ring. Okay, and Adam Pearce has made his way to the ring as a defeated and very frustrated Corey stands in the ring after his and the Falconclaws defeat in War Games. We can assume what Adam Pearce is about to say, but let's listen in to be sure. First of all, I would like to congratulate the Judgment Day on a job well done tonight in War Games. As for you, Corey, and your Falconclaws, I wish it didn't have to come to this. If you would have just complied with my challenges for you, it never would have come to this. But due to your actions over the past month, you've left me with no choice. Effective immediately, you are stripped of the Money in the Bank briefcase, and I am giving it to the man who earned the decision in this matchup, Damian Priest. And on top of that, Alec Winterbourne, E-Rock, Queen Alpaca, Cabbages, Darf, Sword, Tiger Brown, and finally you, Corey. You are fired. On behalf of the WWE and the board of directors, I wish you the best in your future endeavors. Now, please exit the ring and the arena immediately. Okay, and as he is exiting the arena, following him and the rest of Falconclaws being fired, Corey finds Triple H, the one ally among the WWE board of directors and executives that he has had over the last few years. What does a very frustrated and irate and now unemployed Corey have to say to WWE COO Triple H? Hunter, how could you let this happen to me? To us? Again? After everything I've done for you, after everything I've done for this company, it can't end like this. I have to fulfill Zim's wish. I have to be the champion again. I won that briefcase. I earned that right. Please, do something. Alright, after Corey begs and pleads for Triple H to do something to save his and the other Falconclaw's career and return the Money in the Bank briefcase to him, Triple H replies, what does he have to say? Corey, I understand your frustration, but I'm afraid my hands are tied. I've gone to bat for you and the Falconclaws more times than I can count, but the board of directors is insistent that having you as a potential champion, as we are trying to sell the company, will be catastrophic to the future of the WWE. But I can assure you that once the smoke clears and the sale is done, I will do everything in my power to make things right by you and the rest of the Falconclaws. So for now, focus on the WITM Indie and your streaming careers. And keep your phones nearby, because when the time is right, we will talk business once again. You have my word. Okay, so Triple H leaving the door open for a potential return for the Falconclaws in the future once the smoke clears. And the sale of WWE is done, as we know, in real life, late in 2022, early in 2023. WWE was sold to the UFC, and they combined to form Endeavor and TKO, with Triple H still in charge, and he said that once that is done in our WITM universe, he will be open to the idea of bringing the Falconclaws back, and will do his best. Does that mean that we can potentially see the Falconclaws return in Season 9? We'll have to wait and see, but for now, it's time to officially end our time with WWE 2K23, and WITM Season 8. So what we are going to do, I'm not going to worry about the rankings update because we'll show the rankings when we start Season 9. There's really no point since we are not continuing the season, and we'll go ahead and give you your Survivor Series results. In the opening matchup, Raquel Rodriguez defeated Ronda Rousey to remain the SmackDown Women's Champion. In the women's War Games matchup, Team Bianca Belair, consisting of herself, Alexa Bliss, Asuka, and Becky Lynch, defeated Team Damage Control, consisting of Damage Control members Bayley, Dakota Kai, Io Sky, and Nikki A.S.H. And a new United States Champion was crowned as Dolph Ziggler defeated Matt Riddle and The Miz. The Miz being the former United States Champion, Dolph Ziggler the new United States Champion. And in our final matchup of WWE 2K23, here in this Season 8 finale, it was the Judgment Day who was victorious, Damian Priest locking in the bear hug, forcing Cabbage to submit, and forcing the Falconclaws to leave the WWE. Though it does not seem like it will be for good, Triple H leaving the door open for them to return later on, potentially for WITM Season 9. We'll have to wait and see once Season 9 begins just how and when that may happen. But for now, let's do a final wrap-up for WITM Season 8. What we are going to do is we are going to go through all of the Falconclaws, all of the WITM members that we have participate in the season, or at least that have finished the season, as we did have WITM members that started the season but were not still around at the end. We will go through the Falconclaws that were recently fired, see what their season looked like prior to their firing, and then we will officially end Season 8. We'll go alphabetically and start things off with Alec Winterbourne. He was a tag team champion alongside his tag team partner and best friend Ye Rock during his time at NXT. Once they got to the main roster and joined Monday Night Raw, They were part of a SummerSlam matchup where they teamed with Dolph to defeat Logan Paul, The Miz, and Tommaso Ciampa at SummerSlam 2022. However, they were not able to capitalize on that momentum, as following that huge win at SummerSlam, they immediately entered into a rivalry with the Judgment Day. The Judgment Day dominating that rivalry, defeating them in multiple matches for the tag team championships, and then, of course, ending their careers, at least for now, here at War Games. Next up, we have Cabbages, the leader of the NXT Falconclaws. He started off Season 8 by teaming with Youngblood, who later on went on to be known as Devin Rage during his time in WITM. They challenged for the NXT Tag Team Championships, but were unsuccessful. After that, Cabbages decided to go solo, where he eventually became an NXT North American Champion. He would eventually be defeated for it, but try to go for the North American Championship and again, and likely would have gotten another chance had this season continued and had the Falconclaws not been fired. He was invited to join SmackDown, but instead intended to stay on NXT with the rest of the NXT Falconclaws until all these War Games matches ended. Unfortunately, at least until Season 9 potentially, he'll have to wait for his call-up to the main roster. And then we go from one leader to another, the leader of the Raw Falconclaws, Corey. Unfortunately, he did not have a very good Season 8. He, of course, tried to pursue the undisputed WWE Universal Championship. Never got the opportunity. Was traded from SmackDown to Raw in the midpoint of this season. Once he got to Raw, he struggled heavily, going on a massive losing streak. However, did somehow win a Money in the Bank qualifying match and win the Money in the Bank briefcase, a briefcase that he never got the opportunity to cash in, as he was just now stripped of it by being on the losing team at Survivor Series War Games. Next up, we have Dolph, who up until just now was one half of the NXT Tag Team Champions, of course. Being fired, he will be stripped of that championship, but had a very eventful Season 8. Started off as a singles wrestler, eventually tried to challenge Corey's authority, and going to business for himself by challenging Logan Paul, The Miz, and Tommaso Ciampa at SummerSlam. Teaming with Alec Winterbourne and Iraqi, was successful in that matchup. Then eventually entered into a tag team with Sorter. They eventually became NXT Tag Team Champions. He would eventually be invited by Joe Gacy to join Schism, an offer he would reject, and that would lead to the first War Games matchup we had towards the end of Season 8, in which the NXT Falconclaws took on the Small Society and won, securing their future in the WWE at least for another week. Then we have Queen Alpaca. She debuted this season. She is the fiance of Alec Winterbourne. She started off dominant on an undefeated streak on her way to becoming NXT champion. She would eventually be defeated by, I believe it was Roxanne Perez. Once she got to Raw, kind of lost in the shuffle, but she was able to, in her what turned out to be her final matchup in this season, and perhaps for now of her career, defeat the Raw Women's Champion Rhea Ripley to secure the War Games advantage for the Falconclaws here at Survivor Series. An advantage, unfortunately, did not matter. The Falconclaws, of course, losing at Survivor Series. Next up, we have Sword, another man who debuted here in WITM Season 8. He right away would go into a tag team with the twin brother of Cabbages, Dolph, where they had a lot of success becoming NXT Tag Team Champions together. Next up, we have Tiger Brown, perhaps the most successful man or successful WITM member here in Season 8. He captured the NXT North American Championship early on in the season, then graduated to the NXT Championship Division where he became NXT Champion. A very good WITM Season 8 for Tiger Brown. It'll be very interesting to see should he be a part of Season 9 if he can capture any gold on the main roster potentially. And then last but not least, we have Y-Rock. Kind of the same story as we had of Alec Winterbourne. He tagged with him. They became NXT Tag Team Champions together. Alongside Alec and Darth, they defeated Logan Paul, The Miz, and Tommaso Ciampa at SummerSlam, then entered into a rivalry with the Judgment Day, a rivalry that was unfortunately dominated by the Judgment Day, and ended up resulting in the firing of Y-Rock and the rest of the Falconclaws, with the Judgment Day winning at Survivor Series War Games. So with that, we bring an end to WITM Season 8 and our time with WWE 2K23. Not as many episodes as I would have potentially liked to do this season, just I was busy with work and other things, but I hope it was an enjoyable season nonetheless. I want to thank anybody that contributed to the season, including fellow WITM board member Cabbages09, fellow WITM board member SwordofSnow310, former WITM board member DyingBigFish2. Of course, don't want to forget, even though he was not around for the season, Lord Dippy Zims, former WITM board member. I'll always be thankful for him and all his contributions he had in the past to WITM in previous seasons. I'm super excited to get WITM Season 9 underway. It should be more action-packed and have possibly more content than we've ever had in any season if everything goes according to plan. That should start right around the time that hopefully the same week, during the week following WrestleMania, which is about 2 weeks away from the time of this recording, about in two more weekends. That said, again, thank you to anybody and everybody who watched or participated in WITM during this season. I hope you enjoyed our content. And for one last final time, it's time to sign off. Be sure to check out our Twitch channels in the description for myself, SwordofSnow310, and Cabbages09, so you can watch our other content. Be sure to check out our sponsor, W Energy, where you can use our coupon codes and receive 10% off. And for one final time on WWE 2K23 for WITM Season 8, thank you very much to everybody. And this is Corey with WITM Call Wrestling signing off. We'll see you for WWE 2K24 and WITM Season 9 in a matter of weeks.